The narration mentioned that Bilal radiallahu anhu would often give the adhan, and then he would call the message of Allah, and the message of Allah hadn't come out. So he went to call the message of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that he was becoming conscious and then unconscious. And Bilal said, "Wa huzna." He said, "What grief." He said, "What grief." He said, "I wish my mother had never given me birth that I see this day, or that I had died before seeing this day." And then Bilal went to give the adhan and he became unconscious. And then when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam passed away, the narrations mention the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam's body was still not buried. And Bilal gave the adhan, and when he reached Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, often when he would reach this state, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would come out of the house which was adjacent to the masjid, and he looked and there was no messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the narration mentioned that Bilal began to choke and he began to cry, and all those around him began to cry. And for the next 3 days, Bilal radiallahu anhu tried to give the adhan. Every time he would reach Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, he would begin to choke. And then he went to Abu Bakr and he said, "Abu Bakr," because he couldn't bear to remain in Medina without the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And he said, "Abu Bakr, allow me to leave, because I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mention the virtue of jihad. I want to do jihad." And Abu Bakr said, "No, oh Bilal, you stay with me. I need you." And Bilal radiallahu anhu said, "Abu Bakr, if you freed me for yourself, then keep me. But if you freed me for the sake of Allah, then let me go." And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu allowed him to go. And he went into jihad. And then one night, Bilal radiallahu anhu was sleeping. And he saw a dream. And in the dream, he saw the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Oh Bilal, what is it that you never come to visit us?" And he woke up and he traveled towards Medina at a hurried pace. And when he reached Medina, he lay on the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, remembering his Habib. And Hassan and Hussein came and they said, "Oh Bilal, give the adhan." And it was a request of the grandchildren of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And Bilal radiallahu anhu got up and he gave the adhan, "Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar." And the narration mentioned that Medina erupted. It erupted because it brought back the memory of the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The men and women came out of their house, they were ripping their clothes, tearing their hair out, because it reminded them of the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And then Bilal, he tried to stay in Medina, but he found it difficult, because everywhere he would look, it would remind him of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he couldn't bear to remain in Medina, and he left. And then came the occasion of the conquest of Masjid al-Aqsa, and the patriarch said that, "I will only give the key to Umar ibn al-Khattab." And Umar radiallahu anhu traveled from Medina to Masjid al-Aqsa, and all the Sahaba were there. Abu Baydah ibn al-Jarrah, Sharhbil ibn Hasana, Khalid bin Walid, Muadh ibn Jabal. And they went up to Umar and they said, "Oh Umar, request Bilal to give the adhan." And Umar asked Bilal to give the adhan. And the narration mentioned that when Bilal reached Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, those beards of the Sahaba when they embraced Islam, which were black and now had become grey, they became drenched with tears. There was no Sahabi whose beard was not drenched. They had to console Umar ibn al-Khattab, because it reminded them of being in the company of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And this was amazing virtue for Bilal, for he gave adhan in the Haram in Makkah, in the Masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and also in Masjid al-Aqsa. All three of the most holiest places. And then Bilal radiallahu anhu, and the 20th year, he passed away. And the narration mentioned in Damascus, he was passing away. And his wife said, but when she was passing away, she said, "Wa huzna." She said, "What grief, what sadness." And Bilal said, "La." He said, "Say, wa farha." He said, "What happiness, what happiness." غَدًا سَأَلْقِي مُحَمَّدًا وَأَصْحَابًا. He said, tomorrow, غَدًا سَأَلْتَقِي مُحَمَّدًا وَأَصْحَابًا. He said, tomorrow, I will meet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the companions. Can you imagine? Can you really imagine? You know, what kind of iman? Wallahi, you're dying. You're leaving this dunya. And you're happy to leave this dunya. Because you want to meet the message of Allah. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Dunya sijnul mu'min wa jannatul kafir." That the dunya is sijnul mu'min, is a prison for the believer, and the jannah for the kafir. The ulama write, why is it a prison for the believer? Because it stops him from meeting Allah and his Rasul. It's a prison because it doesn't allow you to meet Allah and his Rasul. And it's a jannah for the kafir because this is all that they have. And can you imagine the state that you are dying? You are dying, but you are happy to die. Because you want to meet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And Bilal radiallahu anhu passed away in the 20th year of Hijrah. He's buried in Damascus, Maqbara Bab al-Saghir, in Damascus, and his grave is still there. And many people go and visit the grave of Bilal radiallahu anhu. But this was a man that he may be buried here, but by Allah he's destined for Jannah. And I don't say these words lightly. Allah and His Rasul gave testimony, but there were many other testimonies.